Welcome back. Now, pastoralist communities have experienced a number of challenges when it comes to registering their community lands. This is among the challenges that were highlighted earlier today during the Community Land Summit happening in Nanyuki. Clement Masombo is speaking to stakeholders in the summit. Good afternoon, Masombo. What are you learning?
Good afternoon, Dibal. It's indeed true that pastoralist communities have faced a number of challenges when it comes to ensuring that their community land is registered. And that's the main focus here, sensitization of the community and just letting them know the importance of registering the community land. And I want to speak to some of the stakeholders here who have attended the summit just to give more details on what exactly they aim at achieving by the end of this summit. Thank you so much for joining us live on KTN News. Kindly introduce yourself and tell us, what is the importance of holding such a summit in Laikipia County?
Thank you. My name is Honorable Tia Galgalo, Commissioner with the National Land Commission. Today I'm here to attend this summit. This summit started a long time ago. I think there's been a debate around with the National Land Commission and also non-state actors who are in land sector. And one objective of this meeting is to take stock of what happened since community land registration has been approved in September 2016, and how much progress we've made since then, and if the communities are happy or if there are things that have created a lot of bottlenecks around registration of community land. And one thing that is coming out clearly is that the process is quite long, and the fact that even language barrier to the community, especially the organized communities in the minority and indigenous communities, for them to really to understand the act was one big problem, because it's in English. Even translating in community language is quite difficult. And I think one suggestion was that they need to have maybe in Kiswahili and maybe also do maybe some pamphlets in different community languages. Number two is the fact that the officers that are required, who are supposed to be on the ground to guide communities, are not yet there, especially the registrars who are supposed to take communities through, so that at least they'll be able to go step by step. And there are technical people who are supposed to do that. Most of the counties have not received their registrars yet, land registrars. And I think that's another big problem. Number two is conflict or dispute within and without, within the community, where in some of the communities they have boundary issues among themselves. Say, like, for example, in Isiolo, we have different clans, ethnic groups, and each of them are fighting over a name and also on boundaries, where does the Borana place start and where the zone is ending. So that is also another big problem. Of course, the last problem is the issue of insecurity and the prolonged drought. At this particular time, people are struggling with their livestock, others are dying, and security is also at high peak at this particular time. So I think all these have also delayed the process, and we are hoping that through this discussion, this will be able to be sorted out. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let me also engage another gentleman here briefly. Tell us, in our early conversation, you were telling me that you have faced a very big challenge, especially living, growing up in a forest. How has it been?
Well, living in the forest is a great thing, but now it's a challenge. It's a challenge because when this issue we are discussing today of community land summit, we feel sometimes we are not part of it, because our land still is undergoing conflict between the Kenya Forest Service and the community, the Ogie community, because now the ownership, because first we have to transit from the ownership to now translating into a community land. So we hope the National Land Commission will look into this, because instead of going to the corridors of courts and all this, we should really transform it to a community land, so that we can protect it for conservation and for all the communities, so that we don't need to conflict over land issues, going to court and such like. If the National Land Commission can transform this public forest into a Ogiek land, and it is changed into a community land, we can protect it and have a mechanism of protecting, so that we can have one community land title. This will stop also the massive land sales which have been there, and illegal settlement going on in some forest areas, not only Mau, in some other forest dwellers in Mbabut and other areas in Kenya.
Thank you so much. And Dibal, it appears like even as the Ministry of Land struggles to digitize matters to do with the handling land registration, then National Land Commission also appears like it has a lot of work to do in ensuring that these communities that own community lands finally get registration of the community of the land so that they can have a fair sense of ownership over their land. Back to you, Dibal.
Yes, indeed, Clement. It appears there is a lot to do.